طبعا راح يحكي لنا عن الادوكيشن وعن how to design new curricula I guess في في ظل العالم الاكسبلينشال اللي بيتحرك بشكل اكسبلينشال. The floor is yours.
Concept of exponential thinking, and I think it should be clear for all of you what's exponential thinking and what is the disrupting innovation is. My talk is a bit different. They actually talked about technologies, and they have given a tremendous number of examples on technologies from successful stories of companies, persons, locally and globally. But from my point of view, I think that we have to start with education. We could not have a exponential technologies without having an exponential education, without having an exponential curriculum. They have to go together. We have to start with basics first, then we can talk about technologies and being exponential. So if we ask the farmer 50, 70 years ago, what are the tools that, or the skills your children should have in order to be successful as farmers? And his answer for sure will be, they should be able to milk a cow, plant a field, maybe harvest crops, something like that. Those skills at some point were the skills required to be with a farmer and able to be a successful farmer. But nowadays it's something totally different. Okay? They have to have new skills, okay, to be successful. This is a very interesting fact that I would like to start my talk about. It's from Kathy Davidson book. The book is published in the year 2011. And this is very interesting for you as students. It says that 65% of the kids who entered elementary school in the year 2011 will end up working in jobs and careers that have not been invented yet. This is a scary thought. So we have to prepare ourselves in order to meet that demand in, let's say, 15 years from now. This is back in 2011, today 2017, we're talking about 2030. We have to create new jobs, and we have to prepare our students, children, and the graduates in order to be able to do that. So what can we do, and how can we meet this demand in, let's say, 15 years from now? One way to do it, one thought could be, is to expect what could be the future jobs. We can try to see what can be the future jobs, and we train our students or our children, our graduates, to be able to work at those jobs in the future. So, Alison Berman, she's a writer at the Singularity Hub. She says that it's difficult to predict what careers will be in the future. We can't predict those. We don't know what's going to happen in 15 to 20 years. And it's uncertain what technology-based skills we will be important in 10 to 15 years. So actually, a lot of universities maybe, and Hajjawi faculty is one of them, and Yarmouk University is one of them, we actually did try to change the curriculum. And this was last year. We changed all the curriculum of all departments in the university. And what we did actually, we tried to add new courses, okay, on technologies that we think they are important in, let's say, now or in like 5 to 10 years. But the thing that we did, we did not disrupt our curriculum. We just changed the curriculum. So the question that we have to ask ourselves, and this is very important, what are the skills that we have to teach our children in order to let them prepare to the future? What do they need to know? Okay? And the answer is that we have to disrupt the curriculum. We have to shift from what we call the degree-oriented education to what we call currently continuous learning education. I will talk about a couple of examples from countries around the world who actually took steps into experiential thinking and into disrupting the curriculum of education. Finland is, maybe all of you know, is number one country in education. Okay, Finland actually did disrupt their national curriculum, and they adopted a new model called the phenomenal model, which is, they call it a topical approach. The fact which is by 2020, this is very interesting topic to, or a piece of information to share with you, by 2020, which is like 3 years from now, they will replace all traditional classroom subjects, math, science, history, social studies, all those that we actually used to take in school, and they will replace them by what we call a topical approach. What's the topical approach? Topical approach highlights 4 C's: communication, creativity, critical thinking, and collaboration. Those are the 4 C's that we have to include in our curriculum. Those are the 4 C's that we have to teach our children and our students, our graduates, in order for them to be able to handle the future. Those 4 C's, as David Held, he is a Singularity Hub editor-in-chief, says, those are the central to working in teams and a reflection of the hyper-connected world that we live in now. Now, those are the major 4 C's, the major skills that we have to have in our curriculum. But they are not the only ones. There are actually 3 soft skill education, soft skill educational skills that we also have to introduce to our students and children in classrooms. Those are the adaptability, resilience, grit, and continuous learning. One other example of countries who actually are taking steps forward into the disrupting the curriculum of education is Argentina, and to be more specific, the city of Buenos Aires. This is a quote from the Minister of Education of Argentina, Mr. Esteban Torres, and I like the quote very much that I would like to share it with you and read it very carefully. He says that, "I want kids to get out of school and be able to create whatever future they want to create, to be able to change the world with the capabilities they earn and receive throughout formal schooling. They don't have to do something different, just formal schooling. But in order to do that, these capabilities should," we have to highlight that word and link it to those 4 C's which I have mentioned before. I think that's all for me. It's a short talk, but I would like to share it with you. And I think as Hajjawi faculty, we need to think about our curriculum, not only just to introduce new courses, but the concept of those courses, the concepts of the way how we teach in the classrooms in order to prepare our students and our graduates to the future. Thank you very much.